I'd like to ask both directors, that as a child, what type of programs did you enjoy watching in animation, live action, maybe perhaps even comic books or any other type of artwork? And how did that influence you as a director in your work?
学生の時はその自分は何ていうのかな油絵の絵描き、まあ、芸術家になりたかったので結構その、まあ、非常にアート的なフィルムが好きだったんですね。とはいえこう自分がアニメーションの仕事を始めてからだんだんこうその最初ピンとこなかった子供たちに向けて何か作品を作るとか、よりこうたくさんの人にで作品を作るというのはだんだんこう偉大なことであるとかすごい素敵なことであるというのが仕事をしながらだんだん分かってきました。
제가어릴때글쎄아주어릴때10대이전에는글쎄애니메이션들을봤는데그거를그20살이넘고일본애니메이션들이라는걸알았어요짧게짧게네예예를들면야타맨그래서그아체십하게뭐정확하게알진못하겠지만어릴때좋아했던그런것들이아마녹아있을거예요
I'd like to ask now DJ and Mizuko, you're both professional in this field in a different way. And basically the question is, why do you think the Asian animation became so popular in this country? You both have a different perspective because of your different specialties.
One of the, I think, attraction for the U.S. audiences that is drawn to the so-called the anime, or even as far as Asian, is a lot of, it has to do with, for me, the perspective of storytelling. The storytelling is a very, very sophisticated storytelling. When I say that, it's not the formulaic storytelling of the traditional Hollywood. And a lot of it has to do with the cultural sensibility. I find anime, the popularity of anime, in terms of visual, it's very different also. It's a very melodramatic type of visual representation. You could actually put a character, I mean, most of the anime films that you see have their hairs covering half of their face, and they could be standing on the middle of a soccer field or something, could be pouring rain, and they can just stand there, and then the camera pushes in for like 10 minutes. You know? I mean, things like that, you just don't see that in the type of U.S. films.
The reason why anime has become so popular in Euro-American context is also because there are things about it that are very familiar as well. I mean, some of those things are Japan origin reference, like Samurai Ninja, but a lot of it is European reference, or things like martial arts that have really gotten a lot of transnational distribution. So I think it's that dynamic between the familiar and the strange that makes it so attractive to fans overseas.
The Girl Who Leapt Through Time was first a novel and then adapted as a live-action movie in television, as I was told. What inspired you to make this into an animated film, and how was it unique from the past live-action adaptation?
原作では実はすごくおとなしくて、優等生なそんな感じの方静かな女の子なんですけど全然違う風にしました。今の日本の子たちっていうのは何かこうすごく頭がいいんだけども考えすぎて自分の中ですごい一生懸命これからどうしようかって考えて考えすぎるぐらい考えるんだけど結果的に何もしなくてうちにお腹にずっといるみたいなそういうなんかこう自分の人生に対して臆病な感じの今傾向にすごくあるなと思ってでそれをこうもっとこうなんかバカっぽくてもいいから何かこうそれ構造的になんか走り回るっていう女の子を通して何かこうすごく今の10代の子たちを勇気づけたかったっていうそれがまあこの映画の趣旨というか目的というか自分の中でのこの映画の意味だと思います。
Achi and Seapak is the first animated film
which targets very adult-oriented audience. Is that true? And what inspired you to sort of go to that direction?
그리고 좀 다른 거는 한국에서는 애니메이션을 사실 만들기 시작한 지가 얼마 안 됐거든요. 얼마 안 됐으니까 뭐 이렇게 상업적으로도 경쟁력이 없는 것 같아요. 그러니까 전혀 남들이 안 하는 반대 방향. 그러니까 가령 예를 들면 스토리라인도 남들이 싫어하는 뭐 똥 같은 얘기, 똥 얘기.
What direction would you like either your country's animation industry or the United States or both for that matter? How would you like to see that in the future?
The world is becoming a smaller place, more and more. You know, it used to be divided into different continents, US and Asia and Europe. I really feel that because the world's coming together, I think that if there's a lot of collaboration and between, again, what US does best, what Asia does best, what Europe does best. I think I see a lot of the word co-productions is going on out there, and you have a lot of film that's going to cross over into the different markets. So take the best from each side of the world, put it together, get a good communication going, and you know, you get some really, really good projects.
個人的に思うのは、まあ、例えば、なんていうのかな、こう非常にこう、まあ、インターネットとか、まあ、そうでなくてメディアの発達によって、そんなにその例えば地域差みたいなものっていうのが、むしろあまり感じなくなっていつつ、あると思います。それだから、例えば、まあ、もちろんその国際プロジェクトっていうようなことで、一つの作品を、たくさんの国の人が集まって作るっていうことも意義はあると思うんですけども、例えばまあそれによってその内容がその最大公約数化されるというのがこう平均化してつまらないものになるっていうのはあんまり良くないんじゃないかなと思うんですけど、例えばディレクションする人間、まあ、監督なら監督が何て言うんでしょう、こう、まあ、さっき言った公共性というかこうまあ、その国の中の公共性というか世界の中での、公共性とかね、割とユニバーサルな意識みたいなものっていうのが例えば必要だと思う。そうすればまあコミュニケーションっていうか、そのいろんな人にまあ例えば舞台が違うってことを楽しんでるのが必要なんじゃないか。
I grew up in Japan during the 60s and the 70s. Some of the animation that I saw, I thought it was Japanese, but it was American. And some of the animation I thought it was Japanese, American, was actually by a Japanese studio. So, you know, as a kid, you're not really looking at a program saying, okay, where did it come from? You know, I don't think Pokemon was a hit because the kids thought, oh, this is Japanese animation. They liked it because it was good and it was different.
The panel was excellent too. I was glad to hear their comments at the end. I really enjoyed today. I hope they do it again.
The panel discussion was interesting. We got to see, you know, Korea and Japan, you know, together, and this is a very good event, and hopefully we'll see some more next year and years to come.
일본 애니메이션은 이미 정체성이 있고 한국 애니메이션은 아직 정체성이 없고요. 뭐라고 어떤 스타일이다 이렇게 말하기 힘들고 아치와 시팍은 아치와 시팍만의 정체성이 있는 것 같아요. 예, 재밌었어요. Fun.
すごく自分にとってはいい経験でしたね、うん、本当にね僕この映画はこんな風に映画祭でいろんなところで上映されると思ってなかったから日本の本当にその10代の子たちのためだけのことを考えてどっか作ったところがあるんですね。だからそれは日本でもその10代の子たち以外の人たちもたくさん見てくれたことも同義だったし、今日来てくれた皆さんをねもっと面白くらせるにはどうすればいいかってことをこれから考えるかもしれませんが、
日本、韓国、アメリカの共催で行われた日韓アニメ上映会、参加者426名、 開催2日前に定員を超え予約を打ち切るほどの盛況なイベントとなった背景にはアジアのコンテンツに対してのアメリカ国民の大きな関心がうかがわれます。私たちジャパンファウンデーションではこれからも文化交流の原点である人と人とのつながりを大切にし新しい時代を切り開く活動を行ってまいりたいと思います。